Hello folks, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to set up a simple Power Apps application with one data entry form and how to save data to SharePoint List. So stay tuned and let's go to the demo after this short intro. As you may be aware that you can quickly create an app from SharePoint List which will automatically provision the display, edit and detail forms for you. But what if you just need to collect, for example, employee feedback? In this case, you only need one form which can capture the feedback and save to SharePoint List. Or what if the SharePoint data entry form is part of a larger Power App application? In these cases, the full functional SharePoint Power App application will not be an appropriate approach. Hence, we need to create the data entry form in Power Apps from scratch and link it to SharePoint List data source to create new records. So let's see in the demo how it all works. So if I navigate to a SharePoint site, I will just go to the site content, and here I will just create a new list. I will create a blank list. I will just name it feedbacks and click create. So this is the feedback list. We have a title column as default here. I will create another multi-line text column, which is the description of this feedback, and I will click save. Now we have two columns. I can add as many columns as I want, but for the demo purpose, I will just leave these two columns. So what if you have another Power App application and part of the application is to collect the feedback and the information needs to be saved here? If you come from SharePoint, you can just click on new item and it will display it here and you can create the record. But what if you want this form to be part of a larger Power App application to collect this feedback? So as you can see from this Power App dropdown, you can customize this form or you can create an app. If I create an app like this, it will provision the new, edit, display, and search and query, all those forms which comes with Power App automatically for this list, and it will be provisioned as a new app. But we don't want that. We want this to be as part of another Power App application so a person can fill the information and post the feedback to this list. I'm inside Office 365. From the top left menu, if I click on the ellipsis, I will see the Power App application here, and this will take me to the Power App Studio homepage. From here, I need to select a canvas app from blank. So if I click on that, I will just give this app a name. I will call it employee feedback app, and the format I will leave it as tablet format. I will click on create. Now this will create a blank tablet app for me. From the left hand menu, you can see that there's screen one already created. So what I need to do is I need to insert the form here so we can capture the information, capture the feedback and post it in SharePoint List. So from the left hand menu, if I click on the plus icon here and the edit form I need to select, I click on that. So this will add an empty form on this screen. I need to connect this form to a data source. In our case, it will be a SharePoint List. So if I click on connect to data, and under connectors, if I scroll down, I should be able to see the SharePoint connector. So SharePoint connector, if I click on that, I have already used this connector before. So it is saying that you have logged in with this user account. So I will select account. And then from this right menu, I can select any of the site which are recent site. So we know that this list is sitting on a training site. So we'll select this training site here, and then we can select the list name, which is feedback. So I will click on connect. Now this form is connected to SharePoint List. Now we have added a data source here from that list. The data source name is feedback. So what we need to do is we need to apply this data source to this form. So we select this form, and by default is already selected the data source from this menu, and we will just type feedback. We are assigning the feedback data source to this form. Now if we select this form, and it's saying that there are no fields in this form, so we can select the form and from this right menu click on edit fields and then click add fields. Now we can see all the fields from that list. The default fields and the one which we have created are listed here. So in our case, we'll select title and the description field. Those are the only two fields we want on this form. So if I click on add, as you can see, those fields are added on the form. I can just make this form a bit bigger, and this one I'll probably select this one, and I will make it multi-line, and then I can just extend it. What I can do is I can just make it one column format, and the description I can just make it a bit bigger. Yeah, so we are done with the form. Really what we need is we just need a button to save this information to SharePoint List. So I will just add a button here. So if I click on the insert and button, okay, so if I drag this button this side here and just call it submit, so you can actually submit your feedback. Okay, so now last two things I have to do and we will be done. So the first thing is, when this form will be open, it will be open as an edit form. So if I just show you again, this by default is going to be an edit form, which means that it will try to fetch information from an existing record from SharePoint List and display it in the edit mode. But we actually want it to be a new entry form, so we can change the mode of this form. So if I select the form and from this drop down menu, I will click on default mode, and you can see the default mode at the moment is edit. I can change it to new. So every time when someone give a feedback, it will be a new form. Okay. And the other thing we need to do is that on the button, when someone hit this submit, it should submit the information into that SharePoint List. So I will just need to select submit form, and then I will select which form you want to submit. So the form one. So we actually done, and this should work. But one thing we can add is that once someone submitted, we can redirect that person to a different page, which is like your feedback is submitted successfully, just for the confirmation to that person. So if I go back to the tree view here, and if I click on new screen, and you can see that the success screen already created, there's a default template. I will click on that, and I will just rename this screen, and I will just call it success screen, and I will just change this message. I will just say that the feedback was submitted successfully. That's it. And then what we want is that the behavior of this application is on success, it should navigate to the success screen. So if I go back to the screen one and click on the form one, and here from the drop down menu, if I click on success, I want to go to the success screen. So if I click on navigate to success screen, okay, click on that. So we are done with the form really. So just to recap, we have creating an empty canvas app, and we dropped an edit form in here, and then we connected that form to a SharePoint List, and then we changed the default mode of the form to a new form, and then we also dropped a button, and on the click we're going to submit this form, and then we have created a second success screen. So once this feedback is submitted, the user will see the success screen in front of them, so they get notified that yes, their feedback is submitted. So what I will do now is I will click on the file tab here and click on save, and I will save it to the cloud. Click on save here. This is saving a PowerApp application in Office 365 environment. You can just share this application with other people, or if I just go back one step and I will go back to the PowerApps application landing page, and if I click now on the apps from the left hand menu, I will see the employee feedback app created 21 seconds ago. So if I click on that, as you can see in the SharePoint List, if I quickly go back to that list, feedbacks list, there's no record created at the moment. So if I just click on title, so I will just put some title and some description and click on submit. So this should submit the information into SharePoint List, and also you can see the success message here. So if I navigate back to SharePoint List, there is one record created in this SharePoint List. Now you can see how easily you can create a single form app, and this could be a part of a bigger PowerApp app where you just want to capture some information in SharePoint List, and you just need a new form to capture the information. You're not looking for edit or display form or search form, which is a full-fledged application based on that one single SharePoint List. So today you have learned how to set up a simple PowerApp application with one data entry form and how to save the data into SharePoint List. Thank you for watching this video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video and click the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of my future videos as I upload them every week. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any question regarding this topic or any other queries related to Office 365, put in the comment section below. I review my comments on a daily basis. I will be happy to answer. Thank you.